Hello. In this tutorial, I will demonstrate how to do shadow studies and sun exposure analysis in SketchUp using Shadow Colour. Shadow Colour allows you to select a different colour for elements' shadows in SketchUp and quickly export images and GIF animations. To learn more and download the SketchUp add-in, visit our website, linked in the description below. The first step is to set up the model and the project location. Shadow Colour works with groups and components. In this example, I have the city context, a massing for the approved development, and my proposed building. The groups can contain multiple elements and groups. Next, I need to set up the project geolocation. I will go to Window, Model Info, Geolocation, and set the location. I can do it manually or select from the map. I will set the view to be top. I'll go to Camera, Standard Views, and select Top. Set the camera to a parallel projection. I'll choose my model style from the Style tray and set up the time, the date, and the time zone under the Shadows tray. I can also add a scale bar to the view. On the Entity Info, change the object not to receive or cast shadows. After setting up the model, I will go to my toolbar and start Shadow Colour. I will link elements from SketchUp to Shadow Colour and assign colors for the shadows. I'll click Add Element, go back to SketchUp and select a group or a component. The first element that I'm going to pick is the city context. The shadows of this layer will be on top. I can rename the layer, and under Color, I can select a color for the shadows element, adjust the opacity, or keep the shadow configuration as in the view by selecting As View, or turn off the shadow by selecting None. I'll select Dark Gray. Now let's click Add Element again and select the other elements from SketchUp. This study has three layers: the city context, the approved, and the proposed building. I will click on Preview Image and see the results. We can immediately see the view with the selected colors and the impact of the new development's shadows. On each layer, we can do a couple of things. We can reorder the elements with the arrows and decide which element's shadows will be on top. Under Action, we can disable or delete the element. Under Color, I can assign a color and adjust the opacity. I can create an outline for the shadows by clicking the outline checkbox, assigning color, and changing the line width. I can assign a color for the overlapping shadows with the layer below. Under Appearance, I can do more advanced graphics. As View, the element will receive the shadows as in SketchUp. Receive no shadows. The shadows cast on this element will be invisible. Invisible. Hide the element and keep the shadow shown. If we go back to SketchUp, we can see that my proposed building casts a shadow over the park at certain hours. I want to see the additional shadow on the park, give it a different color, and calculate the shadow's area. I will click Add Region and pick the surface from SketchUp. I will rename the region and change the color of the shadows within the site. When I click Preview Image, I can see the area calculations for each layer, including the overall region area. Under Settings, Preferences, I have additional graphic options. Override the line width. Control the shadow intensity. Turn off the area calculation. Show all elements visible in the view that I haven't picked. Bring outlines to the top. Select Topography to receive the shadows. To save the settings and selections, I can go to File and click Save Settings. To open the saved settings, I'll go to File and select Open Settings. When opening saved settings, Shadow Colour will find and link all selected elements. When opening the saved settings in a different file, or if an element has been removed from the view, I can manually relink elements and regions to the corresponding layer. To export images, I'll go to File, Export, and here I can export a single image. Or multiple images by selecting the time interval. I will select the date, the time, and the time interval. I can also see the number of frames that will be exported. Under Image Quality, I can select between Low, Medium, High, and Ultra. I can also export an image with all the frames overlaid, so I will leave the superposition image checked. I have the option to export a GIF animation. I will check the shadow area calculation to get an Excel sheet with the area calculation for each time frame. As you can see, I got all the images here. The name of the files will be the date and the hour. I have the GIF animation and the superposition image with overlaid shadows. In the Excel file, I can see my region's area calculation of the shadows for each time frame. In addition to shadow studies, Shadow Colour allows me to quickly analyze sun exposure and explore how my proposal receives direct sunlight. It helps me understand where and when sunlight exposure is most prominent or lacking. First, I will switch to the sun exposure mode. I will set up the view and ensure the shadows are on. To run the sun exposure analysis, I'll select a specific date and set the time range and interval. On the time increments bar, I can drag the hour duration increments below the bar, create new ones, or delete them. I can also change the colors. I will then go to the preview image to see the results. To export the sun analysis, I will go to Export and select Sun Exposure. An image file will be exported along with the legend bar. Thanks for watching.